Hello, everyone. This is Professor Hall, and we are looking at figures of the Harlem Renaissance. Today, we are talking about Duke Ellington, pianist and composer. I try to, with these presentations, give you a few people that you might have heard of that you could learn a little bit more about outside of just their name, and a few people that you probably never heard of before. So, for example, we're looking at Augusta Savage 1 week, who is a sculptor and an artist and an educator, and you probably haven't heard of her. A lot of her work slipped into obscurity. Duke Ellington, I hope you've heard of him. A lot of people, he's quite famous. If you haven't, that's okay. We'll learn about him now. So let's get started. Born in 1899, Ellington grew up in a middle-class family in Washington, D.C. He had a talent for music, and his parents encouraged his interest in the fine arts. So he began playing piano at 7 and later studied art as well as a teenager. He was inspired by ragtime performers, and I have a typo there, but he began performing professionally at the age of 17, so quite young. He started playing in nightclubs on Broadway, and then he led a six-piece band, and then later it grew to 10, and then later it was a 14, so he was leading a 14-piece band. And I can't stress this enough. My grandparents were alive during this time. And they, even into the fort, well, really, they were alive. They would have really known more in the 1940s when you still had these kinds of swing orchestras. Every person in the band would be famous, even though it was a huge orchestra. So you would have people who have like their favorite clarinet player or their favorite saxophone player and things like that. We'll talk about Chick Webb in a week or so, and he was a drummer. So he was leading a really famous band, and he had 2 longer residencies at the Cotton Club in Harlem. He was there from 1927 to 1932, and then again from 37 to 38. In the middle, he was with his orchestra and appearing in films and radio programs. He toured Europe twice, so quite busy. It's not like he did nothing during the Great Depression. He was really still quite active. Here he is in a top. I love this picture so much. What is Duke Ellington's legacy? Well, after World War II, he toured the world, as I said. He played with his band in Asia, Africa, and South America. He continued to lead the band until his death in 1974. He really created one of the most distinctive ensemble sounds of Western music. And we're going to hear a clip and see a clip of him, because he was in films, thankfully. We'll see a clip of him in a moment. But he broke away from conventions of band section scoring. So using new harmonies, and he would have combinations of instruments that you might not hear all the time. And especially in some compositions and some arrangements, rather, solos for certain instruments that might not normally get a solo, or it might be in a new and interesting place, right? He was really a star of the swing era. He recorded with other famed artists, Louis Armstrong, Ella Fitzgerald, John Coltrane. These are big names of the jazz era. And some band members stayed with him for over 40 years. So sometimes people who are famous are not the greatest people, but I think that this speaks to maybe the type of person that he was. An incredibly influential musician, but one who really had a lot of loyalty to his people, and the people he worked with really seemed to love him and worked with him many times too. So let's hear it. This is a filmed version of Duke Ellington's Take the A Train. From a movie. We're going to listen to this, and then I have got one more clip for you after.
Take
So I'm just going to pause there where the vocals come in, because it's really the instrumentation without the vocals that I wanted you guys to see here. Duke Ellington obviously playing piano, but leading the band at the same time. So he's, you know, nodding to certain sections and giving little hints here and there, but not the same way that like a conductor would do, right? It's much more subtle. And then you have a little bit of a drum solo and then just the trumpets, and not just one trumpet, right? But a whole group. And it's so loud and different and crazy. And I just love it. So let's hear one more little clip. So this is a couple years later, 1961, I think. Ed Sullivan Show, Duke Ellington and Ella Fitzgerald. I'll just, again, just play a little clip of it for you.
The Duke and Ella. So let's have a wonderful...
Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do-wah, 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 do-wah. It don't mean a thing, all you gotta do is sing. Do-wah, 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 do-wah. Makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Give that rhythm everything you've got. Oh, don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. Do-wah, 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 do-wah. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Mean a thing, all you gotta do is sing. Do-wah, 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 do-wah. Make no difference if that's sweet or hot. Give that rhythm everything you got. Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do-wah, 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 do-wah.
To go until you at least got to hear the great piano solo. I love how they pull back to show you again the whole band, right? Some of those guys were with him in the first video, which was obviously much earlier than this one. So that's Duke Ellington. Look him up. Listen to more of his music. Amazing. Great leader of the Harlem Renaissance music scene, especially playing at the Cotton Club, and had an amazing career for years after the height of the Harlem Renaissance had ended. So that's it for this week. I can't wait to see you guys next week. Thanks.